Hello everyone, this is Saitpreet Kaur and I'm a lecturer at Manhattan Polytechnic College in London. I would like to share an important information with you all related to the mission FATEH, that is about the COVID-19 situation that we all are dealing with right now. We should take some precautions so that we should come out of this situation as early as possible. So as we have to wash our hands regularly, we should use mask whenever we go out, then we must sanitize our hands time to time whenever we are out of our house, and along with that we should maintain the social distancing rules so that we should win against this particular situation and our mission FATEH will become successful. So let's discuss next, that is about the electronic devices and circuits. And today the topic of this subject is direct coupled amplifier. So what do you mean by direct coupled amplifier? As we have already discussed about the RC coupled amplifier and transformer coupled amplifier, and we have gone through their advantages and disadvantages at various frequencies. As I will give you a quick review, that RC coupled amplifier, and the RC coupled amplifier, we have seen that it was having a constant gain at mid range of frequencies, but it was not having impedance matching property, so it could not be used at the last stage of the multi stage amplifier. Then we shifted out to the transformer coupled amplifier, and there we saw that the transformer coupled amplifier was having an excellent impedance matching quality, but it has the problem of frequency distortion, and along with that it was very expensive because of the transformers, number of transformers used in the circuit, and along with the expensiveness it was very bulky too, so it could need a larger space, more space. So these were some advantages and disadvantages of the RC coupled and transformer coupled amplifiers. The last one amplifier that we will be discussing in the case of multi-stage amplifier is the direct coupled amplifier. In this particular amplifier, it is specifically designed for amplification of extremely low range of frequencies, about 10 hertz. That is, when we talk about extremely low range of frequencies, then we can, it will become very uneconomical to use such capacitors or transformers in for some very low frequencies. So that is why we use a direct coupled amplifier where no extra capacitors or any transformers are being utilized, and the simple circuit has been made, has been designed for this amplification purpose, right? So initially we have used here just the input signal, and the input signal is directly being provided to the base of the transistor T1, where this T1 transistor is the NPN transistor we have used over here. Then at the output side, at the collector resistor, there will be another signal connected, that is from the output of the first transistor, the signal is fed directly to the base of the second transistor, and this transistor you can note is the PNP transistor. And then again from the collector of this PNP transistor, that is the output, an RC signal, RC resistance is being utilized, and from here the output of the second stage is coupled to the third stage, and that is again an NPN transistor, and the output for the load, it will be connected from the output of this collector. So in this particular circuit, a simplest circuit with a very few components we have used in this circuit, and we are using this circuit for amplification of extremely low frequency signals. Now the reason why we have used here NPN and PNP and then NPN, then if we have to use more number of stages, then we will use these complementary transistors in the succeeding stages, the cascading stages. Why? The reason behind this is because in this particular circuit, we have not utilized any kind of potential divider bias in circuit for the stabilization of the operating point. So That is why in the absence of that, when the temperature or the humidity or the external ambience will change, then what will happen is the transistor, one kind of transistor will have some same type of changes with the difference in the environmental conditions or the temperature that is being provided or that is the circuit is in, right? So that is why we have used the complementary pair of transistors in succeeding stages, so that if the beta, that is the current amplification factor, or anything will move, the operating point of this will shift because of some environmental conditions, then in the complementary transistor, within the same environmental conditions, they will be lower down. If anything will increase in the NPN transistor, then it will lower down in the next stage. And then again, if it will amplify, then it will again reduce. So if there will be any factors like beta or operating point, they will be shifting from one point to another, and the stability of the circuit will vary, then the use of the complementary transistors will compensate for the same. So there will be no loss in the circuit. As I have written here, the advantages of this circuit are it is a simple circuit with a few components and with a low cost because of the components. Then the disadvantages that it cannot amplify the high frequency signals, and along with that, the temperature affects the operating point at some level because of the absence of any potential divider biasing circuits that will provide the stability to the circuit. But that is why we have used this complementary pair of the transistors, so that it could be compensated. The application is to amplify extremely low frequency signals that will be around 10 hertz or even less than that, and these signals could be, we could get these kind of signals in some thermocouples for some temperature measurements, or in some photoelectric currents that is used in the thermocouples, used in the projectors, right? So the very low frequency signals we will get in the photoelectric current in the projectors, right? Or some thermocouple currents for the temperature measurements. So they are having some very extremely low frequency signals, and if they need to be amplified, then this kind of a amplifier circuit could be utilized. This is all about the direct coupled amplifier. So let's move on to another topic, that is the comparison of the multi-stage amplifier circuits that we have studied till now. First of all, we will discuss about the parameters, RC coupled, transformer coupled, and direct coupled amplifier. What is the difference between all the three on the basis of some parameters that we have written? First of all, if we will talk about the cost, then RC coupled amplifier is having a low cost, transformer coupled amplifier is having high cost, but the direct coupled amplifier having the minimum cost. Talk about the space, that how much space the circuits will take, then it will take very less space. It will take high space, need a large space because of the presence of the transformers in it, but it will be having least space because of a few number of components. Then in accordance with the weight also, it is having a less weight, it is very bulky, more weight, but it is having the least weight because of the fewer number of components. Then if we talk about the impedance matching, the RC coupled amplifier will be having not good impedance matching response. It is obviously the excellent one, and it is a good impedance matching in this circuit, that is direct coupled. If we talk about the frequency response, then the frequency response of RC coupled amplifier is excellent in the audio frequency. Its frequency response is poor as it is not stable and provides a frequency distortion. But in the direct coupled amplifier, it is the best. It is having the best frequency response because of it only deals with the low frequencies, extremely low frequencies. Then about the uses, the RC coupled amplifier is used for the voltage that it is used as an audio frequency amplifier, to amplify the audio frequency signals, and as a voltage amplifier. It could be used, the transformer coupled amplifier could be used as a power amplifier, and along with that it could be used as a radio frequency amplifier, that is to amplify the frequencies of radio frequency range. Then in the direct coupled amplifier, it is used only for extremely low frequency amplification, that is in the range of less than 10 hertz. So this is all about the three types of amplifiers, the multi-stage amplifiers that we have discussed. So if you will be having any doubts in any of the topic, then we will be considering, we will be taking your queries in the live sessions. Thank you so much.